guys, and welcome to Melissa's Pet Life. And in this video, we're going to be discussing crate training, so stay tuned. A great sense of security, be great for housebreaking, and prevent destructive behaviors. When training your pet to use a crate, you want to make sure that you use positive reinforcement and make sure that that crate is a safe place for that pet to go. The crate is a great place to teach housebreaking just because a dog's natural instinct is to den and they do not want to potty where they sleep. So this is a great place to teach them how to not go to the bathroom where they sleep. This is a great way to teach your puppy bladder and bowel control. You can introduce the crate to your puppy gradually and then increase that amount of time slowly over periods of time. At first, you want to leave the door open so that your puppy can enter and exit at will, and then slowly shut the door and increase the amount of time you leave your puppy in the crate. You also want to create a cue word for in and out of the crate to show your puppy when to go in the crate and when to come out of the crate.
Paxton, crate.
Good boy. What a good boy. You want to make sure that you put lots of toys and good positive things in there just so that they associate the crate with good positive things versus negative things. Now, if your dog destroys things in the crate, then that would be a point where you would not put toys and blankets and things like that in there. But if they do not do that, you put toys and cookies and all kinds of positive things in there so that they associate the crate with something positive. Now, some people feel like this confinement is cruel, but it does provide a safe place for your puppy or your dog while you're not home that allows them to be safe in your house when you're not there. So on a side note, if you do have a puppy, puppies can only hold their urine, say if they're 3 months old, for about 3 hours. So you don't want to expect a lot from a puppy if they're being in the crate all day. At night, they can hold it a little bit longer. But if you're having them in that crate for longer than that period of time, then expect for them to have accidents in that crate. So make sure that you're taking them out of the crate frequently. And also, the crate should be seen as a safe place, kind of like their bedroom. It should be seen as a place of comfort, seen as a place of good things. It shouldn't be used as punishment. It should be their safe haven. So just make sure that they're associating it with good things, positive things, and you shouldn't really have an issue or a problem. Now, if they're starting to associate it with negative things, then that may be an issue in the future. I know I have two dogs, and one of them really loves his crate. He sees it as his bedroom, as his home, and then I have another dog that she absolutely hates the crate, and she's always hated the crate, so we typically don't crate her. So it's whatever works for your family. All right, guys, so if you can think of anything that I missed in regards to crate training or anything you'd like to discuss in regards to crate training, please leave it in the comments down below. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, hit the like button, and I will see you in the next video. All right, guys, bye.